While we know too much sodium is a health hazard, there are many things people may not realize about this dietary staple. Nephrologist Dr. Sheldon Tobe says about half of Canadians are sodium sensitive.
Being sodium sensitive means that we tend to retain the sodium that we eat and not excrete it as quickly. The result is that our blood volume increases, and that causes our blood pressure to increase.
Dr. Tobe says factors that increase your risk of being sodium sensitive are having diabetes or kidney disease, having African ancestry, and being over the age of 60. So how will you know if you are sodium sensitive?
You may notice that your socks have left an indentation in your foot, or there may actually, if you push on your ankle, you may actually see a little indentation there. Or waking up in the morning and someone's eyes might be all puffy.
He says another misconception is around salt varieties. While they may taste different, beware of the effects.
All those different kinds of sodium salts, the sea salt and the table salt, kosher salts, unfortunately all contain the same amount of sodium and can have the same negative effect on our physiology.
The daily recommended target is 2,000 milligrams, or 5% or less of the recommended daily allowance per serving. Right now, many Canadians are consuming double this amount. When seasoning food, Dr. Tobe recommends pepper, herbs, and other spices. Salt substitutes are another option, but there is a catch.
Those salt substitutes are usually potassium chloride instead of sodium chloride, and they're perfectly reasonable to substitute for sodium in the diet. There's one caveat, of course. If someone has kidney disease, that potassium can build up and put that patient at risk.
Dr. Tobe says it's important to read labels, follow Canada's food guide, and talk to your doctor if you have any questions. With Sunnyview, I'm Monica Mattis.